alaikum. My name is Waziri. I'm from Nigeria. I'm a PhD student here. So it's a golden opportunity having an interactive session with you. My question is...
louder, please, brother.
During the Rabiul Awal, where millions of Muslims all over the world, we are celebrating the birth of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I come across one of your write-up on Facebook that those that are performing Maulud is bid'ah. So I just want to you to enlighten me more. Why do you think those that are celebrating the birth of our noble prophet, even right point, now here?
Point number one, this question is not on the topic, but it will answer you. This question is out of the topic. Okay. It will answer you because it's talking about me.
Okay,
point number one, the Facebook you're talking about, which gave an article a few months back, that is a fake Facebook on me. That my Facebook has got 17.4 million likes, followers. How many? How many, brother? Brother, can you hear me? Can you come to the microphone?
Yeah, I heard you, yeah.
Did that Facebook we spoke about me had 17.4 million likes and followers? No. There are more than 100 fake accounts on my name on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest. If you know a little bit about social media, any Facebook which has original will have a tick. And that Facebook was picked up by the Malaysian media. Oh, Dr. Zakir Naik says, agrees with the fatwa of the Saudi Mufti. That Facebook may not be his in the ending they're saying. They are picking up a fake Facebook. That today what you have in the social media, there are thousands of posts made by others on me. Thousands. Many are made by my fans, many are made by my enemies. One third of them are actual things what I said in my lecture. They make it and they upload it, no problem. Some things my fans make which I did not say, but it's correct as per the Quran and Sunnah, again I have no problem. One third are enemies of Islam who want to malign me. One poster, Dr. Zakir Naik says having sex with the sheep is good. No, where they get this from? They take my photograph from the Facebook. Correct? So first, as a Muslim, what you should do, Quran says in Surah Hujurat, chapter 49, verse number 6. When you get the information, check it up before us conveying, brother, did you check up whether the Facebook was authentic or not? Tell me frankly, you are a Muslim, correct?
Yeah.
Did you check?
Yeah.
Did you see that article yourself on the Facebook? Yes or no? No.
No.
You read the article in the newspaper and you believe the kuffar, correct? This is the problem. If a kafir is saying Dr. Zakir Naik is wrong, you are believing more in the kafir. What you should have done? Gone on my Facebook, it is there. This is the problem. We Muslims don't follow Quran. What does the Quran say? Check it up before asking any question. Did you check up? How long does it take to just type Facebook Zakir Naik? 10 seconds, correct? But no time,
okay.
Busy. Who's to blame? This is how the kafirs are dividing the Muslims. This is how the non-Muslim media, they know the weak point of the Muslim is there are Muslim sects with different views. So they purposely let these different views come and divide us. Correct? What the Quran says? Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 103. وَاتَسِيمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold together to the rope of Allah strong. Even if we differ, why should we fight? Even if you and I differ on certain things, does it make us to fight? What are you doing? You're helping the enemies of Islam. Correct? You could have gone in your room and checked it. 5 minutes. You want to ask the question in front of the public, okay, and be an agent of the enemies of Islam. Brother, will you get sawab for this? Brother, will you get sawab for this? Yes or no?
No.
I forgive you.
Thank you, sir.
Because I love you, brother.
Thank you so much. I love you.
I said this why, brother? Not to be angry against you, to show you an example. And I thank you for bringing this question, though it's out of the topic. People should not say, oh, Zakir is running away. So if it's a personal question, answer. Because I'm a da'i of Allah. I'm on the haqq. Why should I be afraid? There may be difference. You may see, keep your hand on the chest, someone sit down. So what difference does it make? Yes, you follow what is right, but we should not fight over it. Correct?
Yeah.
If someone keeps the hand on the chest, someone keeps down. Difference of opinion. I do my research, I follow, I may differ. But that doesn't make us Muslim. You know, I've given a lecture. I'd given in Terango. I'd given a lecture in Terangano in 2016. Unity in the Muslim Ummah. If we differ on small issues, we believe in the same Quran, we believe in the same Prophet. If we differ in small issue, we should agree to disagree. We should
agree and disagree.
Agree, disagree. But on the 95%, we are same. So why are you helping the kuffar, the enemies of Islam, to make the Muslims fight? This is the job of the media. And the media, especially the non-Malay media, which I read, majority of the information is wrong. Majority. What they write about me is wrong. No one is taking action. No one. No one. Shame. No one is going and telling the media, where do you get this proof? They're picking up some information, another media, and they're laying allegation, laying allegation, laying allegation, and they're making Muslim fight. They know there are differences. This is what we Muslims, we all the Muslims should be united. We may differ, no problem. We agree to disagree. Don't let the enemies of Islam get better of us. I'm not trying to get any communal disharmony. I'm trying to get the Muslims united. And you know the best rights that any Muslim has, that any non-Muslim has, is under Muslim rule. You see the history. See the history of the world. The amount of crusaders, the amount of torture they did in the name of religion. Even the Christianity sect was tired. And the amount of non-Muslim, they enjoyed security in the rule of the Muslim land. I'm talking about the great Muslim rulers. The Muslim, in Muslim rule, the maximum protection any non-Muslim can get anywhere in the world is in the true Islamic rule, not the fake one. Now, today, most of the Muslim countries are namesake Muslim countries. But those who follow Quran and Sunnah, the best you will find is in the law of Allah and His Rasul. We cannot do injustice even to a non-Muslim. Hope that answers the question, brother.
Thank you so much.